John Hanley, who's Chief Executive of the Nevis Tourism Authority, and Alastair Yearwood, Tourism Advisor to the Nevis Island Government. Talking about the thrust for next year, one of the main focuses is going to be on sports tourism, really led by the success of their triathlon. Perhaps if you can tell us a little bit more about that in terms of the event this year and how it's developed.
This year we'll have the second Tristar Triathlon. Last year we had the first one. It's the first time that Tristar Europe has had this event outside of Europe, so it was really big for Nevis. We have had triathlons for many years before that, but this is the first time that this grand event came to Nevis, and it significantly increased participation in this particular sport.
And how many people has it attracted? Do you think it will raise the profile of Nevis?
Well, the estimation that I had from the organizers suggested somewhere in the region of 200 to 300 persons involved in our various events.
And is this going to be the catalyst for more sports tourism development? I mean, Alistair, is this something that you're involved with, very much
promoting? Yeah, it's not just a triathlon. And last year, incidentally, we had the world champion, the number two world triathlete, and also the number one British female triathlete who competed. So it's actually a very high profile race. And throughout the week, it's also built around offshore swimming. So this year we're going to have the OECS Offshore Swimming Championships. That's on one of the days. There's also a race. It's probably in about our 12th annual cross-channel swim. That's a swim from Nevis to St Kitts. It's about a 3-mile swim. It's very challenging. You can have up to a 4-knot current in the middle of the channel. And people of all ages. We've had a 70-year-old vision man who's done the race. We've also had as young as 10 years old. So it's a week around offshore swimming, and triathlon is the center of this.
And then just quickly finishing off on the cultural side of things, heritage and culture is going to be a theme for next year. And I know you said that this was something you wanted to use to promote the island's links sort of with Britain. Can you give me any sort of brief details on that?
Well, as I said to you earlier, the theme for our booth this year is heritage and culture. Most persons, I imagine, are aware of struggling between Nevis and the United Kingdom. Lord Horatio Nelson married a Nevisian named Fanny Nisbet. As a matter of fact, one of our top hotels on the island is named after her because of was on the side of the hotel. Nevis has been in the spotlight over the last several weeks. Conde, Nast has rated the island, or readers of Conde, Nast, I should say, have rated Nevis as the third destination in the entire Atlantic and Caribbean region. And further, Nisbet Plantation has been ranked number one in the region as well. So that has brought a lot of publicity to Nevis, and we want to say congratulations to Nisbet.
Great. Well, thank you very much, gentlemen.